Okay, assalamu alaikum and good day to everyone. Today we are going to discuss another module, which is module 3 of results and discussion of our bachelor degree project. Okay, so before this we have already discussed about the previous modules, that were the introduction, the literature review and the methodology. So I hope that you have already finished your PSM1 and you have already written the report or thesis until the methodology part. By now your report should be ready up to the methodology part. Maybe you need to do some slight modifications which will be continued until the end of the report or before the finalizing the report, but by now you should have those three chapters ready. Okay, the first draft of those three chapters should be ready by now. Okay, so coming to this module, that will be the results and discussion. Today we are going to discuss very briefly about this. Okay, due to COVID we have to do it online, otherwise we should have discussed it face to face. So hopefully this COVID will settle soon and we can do again face to face discussion soon. Okay, so the learning outcome of this module or the results and discussion part of this project is that the student should be able to understand the importance of achieving the desired results of engineering technology project, the project that you are doing. So you should be able to understand the importance of achieving the desired results. Okay, and then select the most suitable results and relevant results according to the desired objectives. So you will have so many results, but then you have to select the most suitable and relevant results according to what you have already discussed in the first chapter in the objectives of this work. Okay, and then you have to explain the results effectively and clearly so that everything should be clear and the panel should read the results. Not only your supervisor but also the examination panel can get a very clear picture of the project that you have done or the system that you have developed. Okay, and then finally to identify the limitations and suggest the future recommendation based on the results and theoretical explanation. So one of the part of your work is that you have to identify the limitations. Okay, when you can identify the limitations, when you are very clear about the project, when you have worked hard on it and you are very clear about the project, then you will come to know that there were some limitations and you can explain those limitations very clearly. Okay, so we will see the details of all these four learning outcomes in this today's video. Okay, so the chapter content, the chapter 4, let's say, of your thesis, the content should be results and discussion. So results have different types of results. In here we are just representing them by different department names of our faculty, JTKE, JTKP, JTKEK and JTKM. And then the discussion part should have four important things inside, that are introduction, limitations, future research and implications. So you don't need to, you may or may not specify them in the discussion part, the headings, but you have to make sure that all these things are included in the discussion. Okay, so first we will discuss slightly about the results. Okay, results, if we see the results, this is the meat of the report. Okay, so anyone who is going to read the results read the report or the thesis that you are going to prepare, he will go through the objectives first, I mean the introduction part, and then he will just open the results so that he can see clear picture of what you have done. So this is the main thing in your thesis. Okay, one of the most important thing in your thesis. Okay, it provides the evaluation of the design and method used, the design that you have done during your project. It provides the evaluation and also the methods that you have used. Okay, and also it shows the feasibility of what the method that you have used. Is it proper method? Is it good enough for the project? And is it good enough to achieve the objective that you have stated or not? Okay. Different result criteria are based on different departments, okay, or the supervisor, or specifically or the project. We cannot generalize the criteria in one slide, but we can see that we can say that all the projects might have different result criteria. Okay. So, but all the results should have 12 important steps. Okay. That can give the effective writing of the results. What are those steps? We will see in next few slides. First one is to determine the required results. Okay, as I mentioned, maybe you will, during your experiment, you will get many results, and then you have to determine the required results. Okay, which results are important and which results are not important. So you have to arrange the results very well, so that you, the important results can be highlighted in your results and discussion session. And then the organize the data. Okay, how you achieve the results and what are the results. So all the results and the procedures comes under data. So you have to organize the data in a way so that it can effectively show the output of the project. Okay, and then form of data presented. Okay, data is presented in what form? Is it the tabulated form data? Is it the tables or figures or charts or graphs? So you have to select a suitable form of the data so that it can show the output of the results, output of the project very clearly. Okay, and then you have to summarize finding. So all the results that once you have achieved, you have to summarize them in a very proper and clear manner. Okay. Then you have to describe the results. Okay, so once you have done the project by yourself, so you have the good understanding of the project, you can describe the results very well. Okay, and then the description should be very clear of the findings or the results, so it should not be ambiguous. Okay, in the description should be clear so that whenever someone read, he can see the results. Let's say there is a figure, the results are in a figure form. He should see the figure and he should see some description. He can understand the results directly. Okay, then data should be accurate and consistent. Okay, so you have to see the data that you are going to put in this chapter should be accurate and consistent. There should be no inconsistencies in the data. Okay, then you have to summarize the data analysis. Whatever data you are going to show, you must have to give this summary of that data as well. And one of the important thing during the writing of the results, you have to write the results in the past tense, because you have already done the experiments, you have already got the results, now you have put them in the project. So which means that you have done this project and obtained the results a few days ago or maybe in the previous semester. So all the writing should be in the past tense for this results part. Okay, and then sequence of numbering and table and figures. Okay, so you have to see which figures, which tables are important. You have to put them according to sequence and you have to number them according to the sequence. Okay, and then give the proper caption of each of the table and figure. Okay, then number 11 is to provide headings of each of the table and figure. As I mentioned, according to the format, you have to provide the headings of the tables and figures. Okay, the heading should be very clear and it should describe what is being shown in that table or the figure. But then finally, write with accuracy, brevity and clarity. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, the writing should be very, very clear and it should be accurate. Okay, so that the reader can directly get the idea of what you have shown in the result section. It will be good, it will be helpful for the examiners as well as the supervisor and for other readers as well. Okay, so just go through those 12 steps. Okay, first of all, we have to determine which results to present by deciding which are relevant to the questions presented in the introduction, irrespective of whether or not the results support the hypothesis. So another important thing is, of course, the results should be relevant to the questions or the objective that we have presented in the first chapter, but sometimes we will not get the result that we were expecting. Okay, but it's fine. Sometimes the results that are not supporting the hypothesis that we have already mentioned, we can still put it in this section and we can give the explanation why the results are not following the hypothesis. Okay. Then you have to organize the data in the result section in either chronological order according to the methods or in the order of most important to the least. Okay, so you have to decide how you are going to put your results accordingly, and so that it can be seen very clearly. Whenever someone read, he can get the idea, okay, the student have done this part first, then he got this result, then he got the other result, and the and so on. So you have to decide it and discuss with your supervisor. So it's always good to show your results to the supervisor and discuss with him how you can put the results, okay, before you are going to give him the draft of the thesis. Okay, then you have to determine whether the data are best presented in the form of text, figures, graphs or tables, okay, as I mentioned earlier. So you have to decide how you are going to put the data to make it as clear as possible. Then you have to summarize your findings and point the readers to the relevant data in the text. Okay, the summary should highlighting, okay, you should be giving the text like as shown in figure 1, the results predict that something, okay. So you have to give the reference of which table are you talking about, which figure are you talking about. So sometimes you can relate, okay, the figure 1 shows the data that is given in the table 1, so it is in the graphical format and it supports the hypothesis that was mentioned in section 1.1 or 1.2 of the chapter 1, so that you can relate your summary, the result that you are showing, to the hypothesis that you have already shown in the section 1.3 of the chapter 1. Okay, so it will give a very clear idea to the reader. Okay, then it also comes under the description of the results. Okay, and you should know, because whenever you get the results, it's not let's say you are using a software. So if you get some result from the software and you just put it in the report and you don't know what happened here and how you got the results, it will create problem for you. So you have to make sure that you know the theory behind the results, okay, but what have the software done and why have you got such results. Okay, so the theory behind the results or the theory or the mathematical relation or theoretical relation you should know, so that you can easily explain it to the readers or the examiners. Okay, then you have to provide a clear description of the magnitude of a response or difference. If appropriate, use percentage of changes rather than exact data. Okay, so it's always good to show the results and the improvements in the number forms or the percentages. Okay, so try to if there is any improvement that you are claiming that you have improved the results, then you should show it in terms of percentage. How much percent, let's say 30% improvement in XYZ results. Okay, make sure the data are accurate and consistent throughout your thesis. So the data should be consistent. Okay, so if you are using one set of data for one experiment, so you have to make sure that you are using same type of set of data. Okay, so that the results can be considered reliable. Okay, and then you have to summarize the statistical analysis and report actual p-values for all the primary analysis. Okay, so you have to, whatever statistical analysis that you are going to use, you have to summarize that as well, so that it can also help to make the results very clear. Okay, as I mentioned, use the past tense and number of figures and tables consistently. Okay, so table 1 should come first, then table 2, table 3, and each of the figure and table should have a heading. Okay, I think you have to follow the format. Sometimes the format is that the table should have a heading at the top and the figure should have heading at the bottom, but you have to see the format of the report of UTEM, how is it the format, and then you have to follow the format. But each table and figure must have a caption. Okay, so that, let's say, if the examiner just opens directly the results chapter of your thesis, he should get, okay, this figure 4.5, okay, what does this show? Okay, this shows the results of ABC experiment. Okay, so that it's very clear for the readers again. So all these things is just to make sure that the report is clear to the reader and it is accurate and written with the brevity and clarity. Okay, so these 12 steps you have to keep in mind while you are writing the results. Okay, again, what results show actually it yields the knowledge, okay, the knowledge that you have obtained during the project and you have obtained during the literature review. So the results will show that, okay, first part it will show that, okay, these are the results that you have obtained using different methods, let's say using software or hardware or whatever system you have developed, you have obtained these results, okay, but it will also show the knowledge that you have obtained during the literature review. How it will show that part is how good you can relate it with the theory, okay, how good you can relate it with the previous paper results, okay. So you have to make sure that you have a strong knowledge based on the literature review that you have done previously, okay. The result may be specific procedure or technique of for software hardware development for analysis depending on the project. It can be a software, development of a software, development of a technique, or you have developed a hardware, you can demonstrate that during the presentation, okay, or it is just an analysis. So there can be different forms of the results based on the project that you have chosen. Okay, it may be more general, capturing a number of specific results in a model, such models of many degree of precision and formality, okay. So the results can be general, or it can be like a development of a model and making something general for that. Okay, sometimes the results in the solution to a specific problem or outcome of a specific analysis. Okay, let's say you have mentioned a very specific problem in your objectives in the introduction part that you have to solve this problem. So in the result section, it can show, okay, that this is the solution of this problem, okay, that we have mentioned in the objective part. So the results can be of that type also, or the results can create a rule of thumb. Okay, let's say we are going to do some type of experiment, so we can create a rule of thumb that this type of experiment must follow this procedure, okay, in order to get good results. That we have to show and we have to describe in our result section. Okay, so there are different types of results. Okay, maybe you don't need to remember these types of results, but all the results that you are going to obtain will lie in one of these categories. Okay, what are the categories? First one is the procedure or techniques. Okay, you can either develop a procedure or a technique in your results which will be improved as compared to the previous techniques that have been used for the same type of problems. Okay, so you are going let's say you are going to propose a new procedure and improved procedure, okay, or a technique of a specific project, okay, or it can be qualitative or descriptive model. Okay, let's say you are going to develop a descriptive model of a problem, then it will lie in under the qualitative or descriptive problem, okay, or it can be an empirical predictive model based on observed data. Let's say you have a number of data and from there you have developed a model that can predict the results based on the data. So whenever someone is going to use that type of data, so he should use this prediction that the result should be shown, result will be as shown by your empirical model, okay, or it can be an analytical model based on the analysis and based on the mathematical calculations and other things. You can develop a structure, okay, and then the results for anyone who is going to use such type of analysis for this type of data will have the result that you have already shown in this, in your work, okay, or it can be a notation or a tool, okay, it can be formal language to support technique or model that you have developed, okay, based on the calculus, the mathematics, the semantics or other basis for computing or inference, okay, or it can be a specific solution. Let's say you have described a specific problem in your objective, then you are going to give a specific solution that is not general, okay, and you are going to use only this solution for this specific problem, okay. Or it can be an answer or a judgment. Let's say there were some questions raised during the introduction and the objective session. Then you have to answer those questions in your results. Based on the results and based on the explanation, you have to give the answer of that of those questions. Okay, or it can be report. Okay, interesting observations and creating rules of thumbs again. Okay, so these are the different types of results. You don't need to remember, but you have to know that these different types of results you can have. Okay, so all your projects will be under one of these different types of results. Okay, then we will move to the next part, which is the discussion. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, discussion have different parts. Okay, first is the introduction. So you may not have to specify it separately, but you can have it. You will have all these components in the discussion part. So introduction of the discussion is that you don't need to jump to the conclusion or make bold statements, but you have to make sure that all the statements that you are going to put in the thesis, they are shown in the results as well. Okay, so you have to validate the results based on the theory that have already been provided. Okay, then open the discussion section with a clear statement about the answers to the question raised in the introduction, and describe support or non-support for your hypothesis. Okay, so the question that you have raised during your objective and introduction section in chapter 1, so the discussion should include the introduction of these questions as well, and how your findings fit in the existing theories and other research in the field. So this will help, you can explain about this or describe about the findings, how they can fit in the existing theories based on the literature review. When you have a strong literature review, you can relate your results with the theory and the previous results as well. Okay, in the results section, you reported the results. In the discussion section, you must explain your results, include alternate explanations. Okay, now there are two things that we are discussing in this section, that are the results and the discussion. So you can either have one method or the second one. First method is together. You can put the results and discussion together. Okay, you can put one result, you can discuss about that, you can put the second result, you can discuss about that third result and discuss about that. Okay, so this is one method where you can combine the results and discussion. Okay, and you can discuss the details of the results right after showing the results. Okay, so it will be coherent and it can be more clear. But there is another method where you can separate the results and discussion part. So once you have got the results, you show all the results. Okay, just give some basic explanation of the results, and then the discussion part is separately in the end. Okay, so if you have a separate discussion part, you can discuss all the results together in that part. Okay, and in that case, it will be easy for you to compare. So it depends on you if you are going to combine the introduction and discussion session, the results and discussion session, or you're going to keep them separate, okay, based on your thesis. Okay, so different types of results when you get, it's not always compulsory that you will have a matching or the results are exactly same as the previous results. Sometimes it can be similar to the results, or sometimes it can be contrary to the results that other people have shown. For example, you can mention that similar to Smith's 2019 okay study, our results show the same thing as has been shown by Smith. Or you can say contrary to the John's 2017 study, the results show that there is an improvement in XYZ experiment. Okay, so if it is not the same as the previous researchers, you don't have to worry about that. As long as your methodology is correct and your results are correct, you can explain them and you can show something different from the previous researchers as well. Okay, then the second part of the discussion session is the limitations. Okay, all studies have limitations. Okay, you are not going to cover everything, especially because this is your PSM project. So of course you have the limited resources and you have limitations, so you have to specify those limitations in your discussion part as well. Okay, and there are some examples of the limitations. Let's go through. Okay, so this is first example where the limitation is what? My research had several limitations. Okay, you can start with that. The study was primarily limited by its small sample size. Okay, so in here the main limitation is the small sample size. Okay, in the start you have mentioned that the limitation is the small sample size. Now you are going to give the explanation why you had the small sample size, okay, first thing, and then how you can improve the small sample size, how can you get it better, how can you get the bigger sample size, and how it will help you in the better understanding and better achievement of the results. Okay, so in here is say the sample size could have been expanded by including blah blah blah. So what have you according to your project, what could you have included, and then it will include the, it will increase the sample size. Okay, because the main problem, that main limitation that you are mentioning is sample size. Now so now you are going to discuss about the sample size. Okay, and another way to improve the sample size could be an earlier start in data collection. So if you have started the data collection earlier, you can have a much time, more time needed to conduct the experiment, and then the sample size can be increased. Or it's showing another way to increase the sample size is to more contact between the researcher and the target sample may have increased the participation. Okay, if you have gone through directly, let's say you have gone for interviews directly and meet the people directly, maybe you have got more responses and your sample size can be increased. Okay, or it can, ideally the number of participants would have been more evenly distributed across gender, year, in school, athletics, etc. The participants represented narrow range of ethnicity. Okay, so different techniques or different ways is explaining that the sample size, which was the main limitation, can be increased by these different ways. Okay, so participant may have had a better understanding of survey items, had a definition of being included. So one of the definition, one of the way to increase the sample size to is to include the definition of different terms that you are using in your questionnaire. Okay, so this example shows that there was some questionnaire, and based on the questionnaire you got the responses, but the you got responses from very few people, so the sample size very small and your results are not very good or not accurate as you might have expected. Okay, so then that is the limitation, and you have to explain how you can improve the limitation. Okay, so another example. Okay, so this is the only example here. So you can specify the examples or you can relate it with your project. Let's say some of you, maybe because of this is COVID, so now the main limitation for most of the projects is going to be the hardware. Okay, so because you may not have the access to the laboratories, so the hardware, maybe some of you cannot develop the hardware as you have planned in the first semester or in the start of the project. So you can put that as a limitation, but you have to make sure that you cover the limitation by using more software. Okay, so you have to make sure that there are many type of analysis that you have done in the software so that it can cover the shortness of the hardware part. Okay, so you can explain that, and you can relate it with the COVID-19, because of the COVID-19. So you have a good excuse that because of the COVID-19 we cannot access the hardware, but we have shown by different using different simulations and analysis that the work that we planned to do, we have done this. Okay, and we have achieved the desired results. Okay, so the third part of the discussion session is the future research. First was introduction, second limitation, now the third one is the future research. Okay, so whenever you give limitations, so you have to give the solution of the limitation. Okay, so when you give the solution of the limitation, it can lead to the ideas for the future research, for the later students, what they can do, how they can improve this research. This they will get the idea from the limitations that you have mentioned and what the future students can do. Okay, if you had no financial or time constraint, how would you have conducted your study? Okay, let's say in your study you have the limitations of budget and time. So if you don't have those limitations, how would you have conducted your study? Okay, you have to explain that in this section as well. Okay, so that the examiner can know, okay, there was limitation of budget and time, but if there was no limitation of budget time, the student knows how he could have improved the results. Okay, so this is going to show your understanding as well. And then Finally, think of what new items, experimental groups, or procedures you would add knowing your results. Okay, so when you achieve the results, so if you want to say the results can be improved, so you have to explain how, what type of experiments you want to add, or what type of hardware you want to add, what type of software analysis you want to add. Okay, so all these things you can add in the experiments, and then the results can be much better. Okay, you have to mention that in the discussion part, and you must have a theoretical knowledge about that. How you can't just say, okay, if I add something, this hardware, it will improve the results, but examiner will ask you how it will improve the results. So you should have a clear understanding that how this type of hardware can improve my results. Okay, so this is one of the example for the future research. Okay, okay, this is again about the questionnaire. Okay, so a greater depth of information may have been obtained by conducting focus groups. So in here they are saying that they should have conducted focus group results. Okay, and then they should have given one topic for per person. Okay, one topic per person, and it they can good understanding or good feedback from the from the respondents. Okay, in that case they can have a better result, because they can conduct a group interview of participants to evaluate their attitudes, negative or positive, and to identify recommendations for the service provided to them. Okay, so this is one of the example, but maybe in your case you are doing the engineering technology projects, maybe you can mention that what type of software you could have used and what type of software analysis you could have used to get the better results. And in order to verify the results, you could have used the hardware, or you can show the simulation that that is representing the hardware. Okay, if, or you can mention that if I had the access to the hardware, I could have the better results. Okay, there's another example for the future research. Okay, you can go through this. Okay, so these are the different examples of the future research. Okay, so the last part of the discussion session is the implication. Okay, implications are recommendations based on the results. What suggestions could you give to the participants, okay, family or society? Okay, so when you are doing the project, it's not only your project, but you have to show that it is going to help others as well. So what type of suggestions are you going to give based on the result that you have obtained? At least you can give this suggestion to the future coming students, okay, so that they can use your project and improve the outcome of the project and help the society as well. Okay, or the results, maybe it is directly going to help your family, the friends, or the society. Okay, so if you are doing some project that is based on the let's say survey, or how the trends are in the market, so you can give the output of the your project, and you can like guide the family or the friends and society in that report, that how they should go to the market, and they should do the shopping and other things. Okay, depends on your project. Okay, and then most of all, be creative and helpful. Okay, so make sure that your project is not only about you, but it's your project with the help of your supervisor, and you should be creative and you should be helpful to the others. Okay, only the participants. Okay, if you were to help your participants, what would you want to improve? Okay, let's say you are doing a survey, or you did a survey in your project. So again, you know the limitations. Okay, how you can improve the limitations, and how you can help others to go through that limitation and give a very proper response of the survey. It will help the other students as well. Okay, review the recommendation from the studies you discussed in the introduction. Okay, so you have to, before you do your project, okay, you must review the recommendation from the studies. So this is a cycle. Okay, one, let's say someone do a project, he will give the recommendation, so the next person will review the recommendations, okay, and then go through those recommendations and try to improve that project. Okay, so your project should also have the same recommendation in the end, so that the next person that is going to do same project or the similar project, he should review your recommendations and can get the improvement in the results. Okay, so these are the four things that you have to include in the discussion part. First one is the introduction. Okay, introduction. Second is the limitations, future research, and then implications. Okay, again, you may not have to give the headings of these four components, but you have to make sure that all these components are included in your discussion part. Okay, so today we will stop here. This is all about the results and discussion part. So if you have any questions and any inquiries, you can ask the JKPSM or you can ask me directly as well. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum and good day again to everyone.